Hello and welcome back. My name is Lauren. I am another one of your camp counselors. And you've done so much in our GO STEM camp already. You've built a car. You've built the adaptation claw. You've built a tower. You also built Flopper. Now today, in our last session of camp, we are going to be building what's called the Spirograph. Now, what's super cool about the Spirograph is that we are going to use it and it's going to spin and make a whole bunch of different art designs. So that's going to be a lot of fun for us. Now, before we get started, let's make sure that we have all of the materials that we need. First and foremost, we're going to need our Go kit. You also will need a charged battery. So if your battery is not charged, you can go ahead and throw it on the charger now while we're building. But you do need a charged battery. You will also need some sticky notes, approximately this size. So if you have smaller ones or bigger ones, those ones won't work. So we need sticky notes of this size. Does match my bandana. You will also need something to write with. So I chose a mechanical pencil. You can also use just a regular sized pencil or some colored pencils. Now, what's important about this is the size of whatever you choose matters. So it has to be roughly the same size as a pencil, mechanical pencil, or colored pencil. And I'll show you why once we actually start building the Spirograph. Okay, so if you don't have all of those materials, go ahead and go get them. Pause the video, go get them, then come back. And now we are ready to actually build our Spirograph. So let's take a look at the build instructions. All right, I have my build instructions pulled up already. You can follow along with me in the video here. Or if you'd like to have your own build instructions pulled up, that's totally fine. You can do that in a separate tab or a separate window. So let's go ahead and load these build instructions here. And this is what we're building today. This is the Spirograph. As you can see here, this is where our writing utensils are going to go, such as a pencil, and that's where our sticky notes are going to go. All right, so let's go ahead and pop this in the bottom corner so you can actually see. I have my kits here. I'm going to open up my kits so I can get what's inside. All right. Okay, let's get started. Go ahead and hit this button to view our first step. Okay, so the first thing that I need to do is I need to get out a motor. And it looks like I'm going to be putting some of these red connector pins in that motor. So I'm going to take out the little jewel case that contains my red connector pins, and I'm going to keep them right here because I'm going to be using them a lot during this build. Now I'm going to get a motor out here. And as we are building, we want to make sure that we are orienting or facing the parts that we have in our hand the same way as you see them in my instructions there. So I'm going to take four of these red pins, and I'm going to put two of them, one in the top left corner, one in the top right corner, and then two here, not all the way in the bottom, but one above that. Okay? So four of my red pins right there in my motor. All right, let's take a look at our next step. You can see them going in. I need to get the red shaft, so I'm going to take this jewel case out from my Go kit where I keep all my shafts. And I'm gonna put this over here. Now I'm gonna put some of these at the top of this case here just so I can get through some of these pieces. And I'm gonna look for the shaft that has the little red notch at the top. So I can see right here, there's green ones. Here's the red one. You can see it has a little red notch at the top there. Then we are going to put that in this green part of our motor, just like that. So the red part closest is what's going inside the green part of our motor. All right. Next, I need to get this plate. This is going to be our dark gray large plate. So let's go ahead and grab that from the kit. It's right here. Okay. And how I'm going to put this is I'm going to keep my motor just like this. In my gray plate, I want this shaft to go through at the top there, not all the way at the top, but right underneath it. And then when I push, you can see that those red pins are at the top corner there of my dark gray plate. Okay. And then when we push that all the way through, you can see what I have there on my build instructions and in my actual model right here that I'm building, they match up. All right, next we need to flip this over, matching what I have there in the instructions. And I need 4 of these green pins. So let's go ahead and get those out. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And I'm taking the short side. You can say here there's like a short side and a long side. I'm going to put the short side into my plate. We're going to put them here very close to our motor. Remember, short side down. And then I have 2 open holes. 1, 2, before I put the next one in. 1, 2, and put the next one in. Just like that. Okay. So we have green pin, open hole, green pin. When I go ahead and play that, you can see that's what we have. You can always count the holes along with this as we're building just to make sure. Okay, next we need some of our yellow connectors here, our yellow standoffs. I need 4 of those. 1. It's nice they're all in the same jewel case. 2, 3, and 4. Okay. And we are putting these ones, if I rotate this a little bit, they are kind of going every other hole, like you can see here. So this first yellow one is going right above the green, just like that. This one is going diagonal to it, not above it. That one is going 1 blank hole and then another yellow standoff. And same thing up here, 1 empty hole and then another yellow standoff. So you can see they're not directly up and down, they're diagonal there. Okay, when I play this, you can see that's exactly where they go. It's really important to make sure as we are building that you're checking to make sure that what you are actually building physically matches with what we have here in our build instructions. All right, we need 2 of these yellow connectors. Let's take them from up here. And we need to make sure there's this side of the connector that has this little bump inside. We want to make sure that that's facing down, okay? And then we're going to connect those right here just like this. So again, make sure that little ridge on the connector is facing down towards your plate, and we're going to connect them just like that, okay? All right, what's next? We need 2 yellow large beams, which are right here in my kit. So let's get 2 of those, okay? And they're going to attach right here on my green pins. You can actually see that there when I go ahead and play that. So when I put the first one on, I need to push really hard to make sure that it goes all the way down. See how there's this gap there? We don't want the gap, so keep pushing until it goes all the way flush. Okay, all the way down, and let's go ahead and do it again. You can see I actually fit both of them on there. Okay. Doing great so far, building our Spirograph. Okay, we need 2 blue connectors, but you see this little 2 times there? We'll be doing this twice. So I actually need 4 of them. So let's go ahead and get 4 blue connectors out. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let me put this to the side for 1 second. And we need to really pay attention here. The way that I'm holding this, this little ridge bump here is facing to the right. That's the way I'm holding it. I'm going to take 2 red pins and put them right here at the bottom. And then I'm going to take another blue connector and have the prongs facing down and also the ridge facing to the left. And I'm going to connect them right here on my red pins, just like that. Let's do it one more time. Ridge facing here to the right. 2 red pins connecting here at the bottom. Taking my other blue connector, flipping it around to make sure the little prongs are facing the bottom and the ridge is facing that way. And then I'm going to connect these just like that. Okay. So I have 2 of those. Just like that. Okay. Now I'm going to add them onto my build. So you can see here the way that I have them connected, just like that. I'm going to take this, make sure it's matching what I have over there. I'm going to take this, make sure my little edge here is facing to the right. I'm sorry, my little ridge right there at the bottom is facing to the left. Go ahead and put that down. Put that down just like that. Okay, so remember you want this little ridge at the bottom facing that way, just like I have here in the picture. Okay, what's next? Okay, I'm gonna put two red pins inside my motor. Let's grab two red pins, put them right inside my motor, just like that. I'm gonna flip it upside down, and I'm gonna grab one of these red gears, and I'm going to put that onto my shaft right here. I'm gonna push that all the way down. Now you might need to turn it a little bit because it's actually square, so it needs to fit on that shaft. All right, now I need two green shafts. They're gonna be in the same jewel case right here, and they're gonna go right in the middle of those two yellow connectors that I have there. Okay, let's go ahead and find two of those green shafts. Take some of these other pieces out. You are doing a fantastic job following along with me building our Spirograph. We are really making a lot of progress here. I can't wait until it's finished and we can play around with it. All right, I have my two green shafts right here. So I'm going to make sure that the green portion up here is facing up, and then I'm going to put them right in the center there of my two yellow connectors, just like that. Okay? All right, now I'm going to need a blue gear right here, and I'm going to put this on the left shaft. Now when I do that, I need to make sure that my shafts actually mesh together. So you might need to move them around a little bit until you get them actually together, just like that. Okay? All right, now I need right here, this is called the red square beam. It's going to be right here in my kit. I'm gonna grab one of those. I'm gonna put that right on top of this shaft that my red gear is on, just like that. And then I'm gonna need a rubber shaft collar, and that's gonna go on the end of this. Rubber shaft collars are right here. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that right on top, just like that. So this is what it looks like. That makes sure that when I turn that over, this red shaft doesn't actually fall out. Just like that. All right. I need two more of these red gears. Just like that. And I'm gonna flip my build over and they're gonna go right on top of these green shafts. Now be careful when you flip this over because this green shaft could fall out. So go ahead and hold that in place. Okay. And these two red gears are gonna go right on these green shafts. Gonna push them all the way to the bottom. Once you do this, you don't have to hold it in place anymore. That will hold it, okay? All right, next, I need to get one of these plain shafts. They're actually gonna be found right here in my kit. Here's one of them right here, okay? I need one of those. I need a blue gear. And I need a shaft collar, okay? So what we are going to do is we're gonna push this blue gear through the shaft about halfway, like this. And then we're gonna put the shaft collar right on top. So push that all the way down till it looks like that, okay? Now I'm gonna add that to my build, okay? So I'm holding this the same way. Now I'm putting this here in this first hole, right next to the two green pins, just like this. Now when I put it down, you might need to move it around a little bit so that it actually goes in with the red gear. And you wanna make sure when you spin that red gear, the blue one spins too. That means that they're connected. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and flip this over. Go ahead and hold this shaft, because when you flip it over, it could fall down. And I'm gonna rotate this so it looks the same as what I have in my instructions. I need one shaft collar, and I'm gonna put it on this shaft so that it doesn't fall out, because I'm holding it in place right now. I'm gonna put that shaft collar in there to make sure it doesn't fall out, and then I can let go, okay? All right, next I need to grab a black plate, which is right here. I'm gonna put this to the side just for a second. I need a black plate. I need two green pins, and four red ones. So I'm gonna push, now when we do this, we wanna push the long side into the black plate, not the short side like we did last time. Long side in all the way. Okay. Long side in all the way. They should be poking through the other side. And then four red connector pins here along the edges. Remember, this is a video. If you need to pause at any time or rewind it, if you miss something, you absolutely can. Okay, now we need to grab a large white plate and a large gray beam. So here's our white plate right here. And our large gray beam is up here. And we're gonna put them together just like we see in the build instructions, just like this. Gonna line them up like that. So it looks the same as what I have, okay? And then what we're gonna do is this green, we're gonna flip it over like this, and the green's gonna be facing me. So these red pins should be just like that all the way through. And we are going to put this green part in the top hole of the white, and then everything else is going to line up just like this. Actually see what it looks like there. Okay, I like to put them in the white part first, then line up my gray beam and then push it all down just like that. Okay, so you should see two empty holes here on both the gray and the white, and then your green pins should be sticking up just like that. Okay, I need two more red pins, and they're gonna go right here at the bottom of the black plate. Okay. I need two more yellow connectors, and the way that they are going to be placed is really important. Two more yellow connectors. I'm gonna hold that this way. Remember, we want that little notch side down facing the plates. I'm gonna spin it around. Put that on just like that. Okay, we have these two connector parts facing me. Put the other one on just like that. This is what it looks like. All right, next, we are going to take this part of our build and we're gonna flip it over so it looks like this. Our motor's on the left side. And I'm gonna take what I just built, flip it over. This long part of the gray beam should be facing towards the motor. And the very, very edge, this edge of the gray beam and white beam down here, are gonna connect to the blue connection points right here. Now, everything's gonna snap into place when I do this, so you may need to wiggle it around a little bit, okay? Because we have a lot of stuff connecting. We have these four blue parts of the connector is now in the gray and white. We have the two red pins that were on the motor are now connected right there to the edge of our gray beam. And the shaft is now through. It should be right next to those. The shaft is right there. Should be right next to those two red pins. Okay, so we had a lot of stuff connect at once. So please check this step before moving on to make sure everything is connected properly. All right, I need two of these dark gray beams. I'm gonna set this to the side. They're right here above the pink ones. And I need six red connector pins. So they're gonna go four in a line right here at the top. And we need to do this twice. I can see the two times there on my build instructions. One, two, I'm going down a line here. Three, four, like that. It's four in a row. Then I'm going to put two down here at the end on the other side. So six total. Okay, one, two, three, four, two at the end. Okay, make sure we do that twice. And this is what we have. All right, and I need a dark gray large beam and a dark gray large plate, and they are going to connect like that. Okay, which is this, and we are going to need one of these right above the orange, okay? So we're going to put this one on first, the smaller one. We're gonna leave, I like to put one side on then the other. We're gonna leave one pin, we're gonna take the edge, put it right on there on the edge. Come over here, leave one pin, put it right there on the edge like that. It's easy to do it when you have it on a surface. Then we're gonna take the gray, our large gray plate, and we're gonna put it on, but we're gonna leave one pin open at the bottom. So you should have one pin open on every of the four corners. Okay, I need two yellow, we're doing this twice, so I need four yellow beams and two orange beams. So let's come up here. I need four yellow beams, okay, and two, I'm gonna set this to the side, and two orange beams. Okay, now let's see how these are gonna connect. Okay, remember we're doing this twice. So I can see for my, let's take one orange beam first. I am going to put red pins on the two ends, like that. I'm gonna skip a hole on either side and then put two more. So there's four red pins per orange beam. It should look like this. Okay. Then I'm going to take two of my yellow beams, take the edge of one and pop it on the middle. The edge of this one, pop it in the center. Just like that. Okay, let's do it all over again. Four red pins, one on each of the sides. Okay, skip a hole, put another red pin. Other side, skip a hole, put another red pin. Take my yellow beam, take the edge, put it in the center. Same thing on the other side. So I have two of these. Okay, you can count at the top there. You should have four red pins. All right. I'm going to take this that I just built. We want to make sure that the smaller gray beam here, or this plate that we have, which is the dark gray large beam, that's going to be at the top. Then we are going to take these and place them right on the edges, just like this. Okay? Fit in there very nicely. Okay, I need two pins. They're gonna come right here in the center. And if I count from this open hole, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, and then diagonal, just like that. Take my red, put that right on top, just like that. Okay. I need two blue standoffs. It's gonna be in this jewel case here. And I'm gonna put them here inside our red square beam where we don't have the red pins already. Just like that. I'm gonna add another red square beam right on top. Just like that. Okay. Now we get to add it to our build. How cool. Okay, so I'm going to flip this over. I'm gonna make sure that this blue part here at the bottom is facing me. I'm gonna flip this over. Now the center of these red beams is gonna attach to that standoff just like that. Okay, so I'm gonna put that in the middle of the red beams. I'm gonna push until I can't push down any further. It's gonna be a little bit of a gap. It's gonna look like this. It can wiggle a little bit. I'm gonna push until it can't go down anymore, but be careful, we don't wanna break anything. I'm gonna put this straight down like this, and this should be able to turn. Oh, you can see where the spiral part of the spirograph is coming in. That's gonna be so cool. All right, and that's where we're gonna put our sticky notes. So make sure you have sticky notes. We're gonna take our sticky notes here and I'm gonna now put them in my build right on top, just like that. This is why I was saying earlier, how big your sticky notes are matters because we want it to fit right in the build just like that. Okay, next, I need a large white plate. Let me move this off to the side. Large white plate, and I need two more of the red shafts. And they are going to go right in the middle there, just like that. So I can count here. We're going to go up two and then this middle hole over two. And that's where this is going to go. We're going to put the long part down so that the small part of the shaft is sticking out. We're going to skip a hole and then we're going to put that on the other side, just like that. Okay, I'm going to lay this diagonal so nothing falls out. I'm going to take two more of my red gears and I'm going to put them on this short side of the shaft so they don't go anywhere. Just like that. They should be able to spin. Okay. Put that down. Okay, now we're going to attach that to our build. Okay, so be careful with this. You don't want to flip it all the way around. I'm going to turn it a little slightly. You can see these yellow parts of the connectors. We are going to have our gears going inside like this. So the long parts of the shaft should be facing out. We are not going to connect right on the edge. We're going to skip a hole and then connect those to the yellow parts. So you can see right there, I skipped a hole and then I connected to my yellow. So I didn't put it right on the edge. Okay, put that down. All right. Next, I need a gray plate right here, and I need two of my orange connectors, which are top right up here. How I'm going to connect those is they are going to go. Make sure that our little indentation part right there is actually facing this way. We're going to put that right on the edge of those bottom two, just like this. Make sure those snapped in all the way. Then we are going to skip one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And we're going to put this on the fifth hole. Make sure the little part where your gap is facing this way to the left. Like I said, we're going to skip four and then put this in. Just like that. You should have two empty holes here on the right side. Okay. All right. I need four of these guys here, the red connectors. And I'm going to put the red connector pin on the flat side. So you can see here, there's a side that has this little indentation there. And I am actually going to be putting them on the flat side. Okay, so turn them over, take four of these and put the red pin on the flat side, not the side with the little lip at the top. Okay, I'm gonna do that four times. Remember, putting the pin on the flat side. Two, three, four. Okay. All right. Now I'm going to take this here, this gray slide block. It's actually right here in my kit. I'm going to take the actual slide part out just for right now. And I'm going to connect these, the little lip part should be facing up where this slide part actually is, just like this. One, two. The flat side with the pin should be facing down, just like that. Okay. Three. All of the pins should be facing downwards. Please make sure all four of your pins are facing downwards. Okay. We're going to connect that onto here, make sure that we're holding this correctly. And we're going to put the slide part right here. Remember how we had those two holes left? That's where these connectors are going to go. All four of them, just like that. Okay, so the slide should be facing like this. Okay, let's go ahead and put this slide piece back in so we don't lose it. Next, we're going to attach that to our build. So let's go ahead and bring our build back. This long piece of the gray beam. As we can see here, the part with the slide is going to be facing to the left. So let's go ahead and turn this way. And the very edge of this gray connector is going to go into these last two holes. And that should fit on your build very, very nicely. So make sure everything gets lined up. Go ahead and snap that in. You can see that's what that looks like there. Okay. Okay, put that down carefully. All right, next I need a white beam right here above the pink one. I need two more yellow connectors. Now for this, remember that little, the indent side is gonna be facing downwards. I'm gonna put that right here, the very end of this plate or this beam, white beam. And then I'm gonna do that on the exact opposite side. Please make sure that that little part of the yellow connector is facing down, just like that, okay? Next, I need a blue standoff and a spacer, and that's gonna go right in the middle. So a blue standoff's gonna go right in the middle of my white beam, and then a spacer is gonna connect right on top of that, just like that. Okay, I need another one of these gray slide blocks from right here. Let's go ahead and take this slide part out and put it back in our box. Now I want the slide part facing me, and I'm gonna put two yellow standoffs right here on the left side. Okay, just like that. This is where our pencil is going to go. So go ahead and take the pencil that you have. I'm gonna be using a mechanical pencil, but you can use whatever you want. Just gonna have to push that in till you hear the snap. Okay, my pencil is now in, just like that. If you have too big of a pencil, go ahead and find a different one. You want it to be able to fit inside there. All right, now we're gonna connect it here. So take this just as I had it. And the yellow standoffs are gonna go right on the edge there of that yellow connector, just like that. It's gonna hold our pencil while we draw. Okay. We're gonna need another one of these white beams. And I'm gonna put a yellow standoff on all the way on the left side and a blue standoff all the way on the right side. Okay, just like that. Now I'm going to take a blue connector up here, it's my last one, and a blue standoff. The blue standoff is gonna go right in the middle here. So I see those two holes at the top, it's gonna go right in the center, just like that. And then I'm gonna put a spacer on top of that, just like that. Okay, now that's going to go, let me hold this correctly, my white beam, the yellow connector's on the left. This is going to go with the spacer facing up right in the middle, just like that. Okay. Next, I need another yellow connector and I need one red pin, making sure this little bump part of the connector is facing this way to the right. Put my red pin in the top right, just like that. Now I'm going to connect that now to this piece that I just built. I'm gonna turn it down a little bit, and the red pin should be facing me. It should be facing this way. And I'm gonna connect that here. I should have two blue and then get right into my yellow connector. Okay, now we're gonna connect that to our other piece. So I'm gonna flip this over. I'm sorry. This is the way that I want it to be. My pencil should be facing to the left. This middle part of the yellow connector is going to attach to the red pin, just like that. And you should see that this actually moves. Okay, put that down. All right, we need to get a rubber band. Now this is a little tricky, so let's go through this together slowly. Get a rubber band from my kit right here. Now, we're gonna hold it with the pencil down like this. I'm gonna take my rubber band and we're gonna go on this bottom part and pull up. We're going to go around, all the way around until we can hook it on to this other spacer. Okay, keep pushing till it's hooked all the way on. So this is what it should look like. So I started here, hooked it all the way around and then underneath my other spacer. Okay. We're gonna attach it to our build. Oh my goodness, we're almost finished. So let's pull out our build again. Okay, we are going to take this part. My pencil is now facing over here. Okay, I should have the blue standoff on the left side. That blue standoff is going to go in the middle of this slider. Let's do that first. Slide it back. Then this yellow standoff Let's push this. We're going to put our pencil, actually go ahead and put it right on top of your sticky note. This yellow standoff is going to go in the corner of this red connector. Let me show this to you a little bit closer. Okay. This is going to go in the corner of your red connector, just like that. So blue standoff should be in the middle of your slider. Yellow standoff should be in the corner of that red connector. Now let's attach our switch. Our switch is right here in the electronics part. We are going to attach this wire coming out of our motor to the plus part of our switch, just like that, till you hear the click, okay? Then we are going to need our battery, and we're gonna attach that to the minus part. So I'm gonna take the battery out. We are gonna attach that to the minus part. Now, one other thing you could look at is this orange wire should be connected to the orange part right there, okay? Till I hear the click. Okay, now we're almost done. When I'm looking here, I'm going to need a red gear. I can put this away. Put these pins away. I need a red gear. I need a blue gear. And I actually do need a... I need a rubber shaft collar. Now, I'm going to turn this to the side. Please be careful that nothing falls, okay? On this first standoff, I'm going to put my red gear. On the blue standoff here, I'm sorry, on the right shaft is going to be my blue gear. And I'm going to put my shaft collar there on the blue gear, just like that. So the red gear should be on the left. Blue gear should be on the right. Let's go ahead and put this down. Be very careful. Now, the rest of the build instructions are going to show you how to swap out the gears. We will be doing that here in a second when we actually test our build. But just as a reference, you can always come back to these build instructions so it can show you how to swap the gears. You're going to see there's three different ways that we can have the gears. We can have red, then blue, green, then green, or blue, then red. So congratulations, you built your Spirograph. All right, here's the moment we've all been waiting for. Go ahead and take your switch. Let's actually watch our Spirograph move. I'm gonna push the switch up in the positive direction. Here we go, 1, 2, 3. Watch it go, look, it's spinning. It's actually making a design. How fun is that? Whoa. So this is really, really fun. Congratulations, you just built your Spirograph. You can take this up, you can pull that sticky note off. Look what we made. That is so cool. Congratulations, you did it. You built the Spirograph. Now, are you ready to test our Spirograph? We are gonna change some of these different gear configurations, and we are going to make a lot of different art designs, because not only does your switch move in the positive direction, it also moves in the negative direction. Now, do you think that that's going to change the way that it draws some art? Well, let's go ahead and we're gonna find out.
Hello, as you may remember, my name is Audra and I am another one of your VEX Camp counselors. We have just built this amazing Spirograph and now we are going to use it to make a whole bunch of really cool Spirograph art. So I bet you're wondering how that happens. Well, with Lauren, you turned it on and got to see it start to move and make a design. But there are a bunch of different designs that our Spirograph can make. So first, we're gonna see what all those different designs are, and then we're gonna use them and layer them together to make some really cool artwork. Are you ready? Okay, let me switch my camera view so you can get an up-close shot of what we're going to do. As always, if you need to pause the video for any reason, you can pause it and rewind or replay if you want to see anything that's happening or see anything happen again. What you're going to do is you are going to follow along with me as we test all of the different gear configurations and the directions that our Spirograph can move. So you're probably wondering what exactly I'm talking about. Well, here, I'm going to tilt mine so that you don't have to tilt yours. On the outside of our Spirograph, we can see these two gears here. Well, depending on which gear configuration we're using and which gears are on these two shafts, that will change the way that our Spirograph moves, and that will then change the design that's created. The other way that we can change things is to change the direction that our motor is turning. So depending on the direction that our Spirograph is moving, that will also change the design. So to get started, we're just going to make several different designs using all of these different combinations of things in order to see all the different things that our Spirograph can do. So first, I've got myself a clean sheet of paper here. You want to make sure you have a clean sheet of paper as well. And I'm just using a regular pencil for this part. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to test the gear combination of red on the left and blue on the right. So, and then we're going to turn the switch towards the plus sign. You can see the switch has a plus sign and a minus sign. We are going to go in the positive direction and see what that does. Are you ready? I'm going to count down 3, 2, 1, then we're going to hold that switch together. 3, 2, 1, go. So now I can see that my Spirograph is starting to move and turn, and I can see this awesome design that's getting created. Now, the longer it moves, the darker those lines are getting. So depending on how long we hold this switch, that will determine how dark our drawing is, right? So I'm gonna hold it for about 3 more seconds and then let go. Okay, take a look at this drawing. So I'm gonna peel this off here so that you can see it up close. So your drawing should look something like this, right? We've got a bunch of tight spirals. We can see how if we keep following, we could actually follow our finger because it's one line that's making all of these different designs. So now I'm going to put that over here to the side and I'm going to label this so that I can remember what design this was. So this has the red gear first and then the blue gear. So I'm going to use some markers to do this. So a red plus a blue, and this was going in the positive direction. So I'm going to make that red, blue, plus. All right. Now I'm kind of curious how that will change if I turn my switch in the opposite direction. So now we're going to use the same gear combination of red and blue, but we're going to push our switch to the negative side. How do you think that's going to change the design? Bet you can get an idea in your head. Are you ready? We're going to do it together again. 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, it looks like the way that this design is shaping up, I've got some bigger shapes that are getting drawn. Uh-oh, it seems like sometimes my Spirograph is getting stuck. I wonder if yours is doing that too. So it seems like sometimes my gears, while they're meshed, are slipping a little bit so that they kind of get stuck and they don't keep moving. So there's a few reasons that that can happen. One is that they're just not exactly solidly on this shaft. See how this one has a shaft collar on it that holds it in place? This red one does not. So I'm going to make a small modification to my build here just to help it work a little bit better. And I'm going to add a second shaft collar from my kit to this second shaft over here. Now, something that I like to do that helps, if we turn our, I'm going to do this so you can just watch and see. If I turn my Spirograph around, you can see how all of the gears inside here are meshing and connecting. So our gears on the outside are held in place by tiny red gears on the inside of our Spirograph. So when I go to attach my extra shaft collar, I'm actually going to poke my finger in the back there and press on that red gear to make sure that this can get as tight as possible. And then I'm going to push that shaft collar on top. So now my red gear is held in place a little bit better. I'm also going to check on my blue gear, make sure that's still nice and tight. And now let's see if our Spirograph will keep moving and not get stuck. So I'm going to take this piece off. And now let's see if our Spirograph can keep moving. Here we go. Ready? 3, 2, 1. And there we go. Now it's moving a lot more smoothly and I can watch my gears and see that they're really staying meshed together a lot better. There's not as much slipping, they're not wiggling around as much. And my drawing shows that really clearly because now I'm not getting dark spots in one area or watching when my pencil isn't moving. So we can see here that this drawing is a bit similar to the positive direction, but it gets a little bit bigger. So we're gonna stop it in about 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1, stop. And now we're going to take this sheet off and we are going to label it the same way we did for the other configuration, for the other direction. So this is, again, this is our red gear plus our blue gear. And this was going in the negative direction. Do you have a favorite already? Sometimes I find that when I do this, I end up with favorite designs. Okay, so now that we've tested this red and blue combination in both directions, now we are going to get ready to swap them and try a different configuration and see how that changes the design. So all we're going to do is pull off the shaft collars from both of these shafts. And then we're going to pull off the two gears from the outside, one and two, and we're going to flip them. So I'm going to put the blue gear on the left, again, with the flat side facing the white plate the same way it was before, and the red gear on the right. And again, I want to make sure that they're meshed. Now, if you want to hold them in place with your finger inside that little box there, you can, just to make sure. And then I'm going to stick with that two shaft collar modification because that seemed to work really well for me the last time. So I'm going to stick with that and put two shaft collars back on. So now we have a larger gear driving a smaller gear. So let's see how that changes my design. Now from tipping it around a little bit, you can see I have a little bit of a mark on my paper, but that's okay. All right. So first we're going to test it in the positive direction. Are you ready? Let's do this together. 3, 2, 1, go. Whoa, that is a completely different design than the first one. And as it goes around, you can see that that mark and that design is getting darker and darker as the pencil traces over its line. So we'll hold this for about 3 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, and let go. Look at the difference between these two designs. All we did was flip the gears, but we have a completely different pattern emerging here. Here we had small, tight spirals, and here we have larger spaces between those spirals. So let's label this design so that way we can see it. So this one is our blue gear first, then our red gear, and this was going in the positive direction. Okay. What do you think is going to happen now that we've seen 3 different ways that this works? What do you think will happen when we change it to the negative direction? Here it looked like it got a little bit bigger. Do you think it's going to get bigger than this? Do you think it's going to make more loops inside? I don't know. So now we're going to pull our switch towards the negative direction and find out. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, here we go. Oh, it looks very similar. But maybe it is a little bit bigger. This one seems like it has more of a rounded shape, where this one has a little bit more like a clover type shape. All right, we'll let it stop in 3, 2, 1, let go. Look at that. Okay, now we're adding to our design repertoire here. I wonder if your favorite design has changed since that first one. Now that we have 4 different designs, which one do you like the best? And I bet you can start to see maybe some ways that we might be able to use this to make some different kind of art later. So let's label this one too. So this one, we again have our blue gear first, then our red gear second, and this is going in the negative direction. All right, so now we've made 4 different designs. And you're probably asking yourself, wait a minute, Audra, I don't have any more gears. Aha, but you do. So there are 2 more gears in your VEX GO kit. They are in the side with the plastic pieces, and they are 2 green gears that look just like this. So take a moment and go get those gears out of your kit. And we are going to find out what a 3rd gear configuration can do to our Spirograph designs. So once you have your 2 green gears, we're going to do the same thing we did when we swapped out the red and blue. I'm going to take off both of these shaft collars. I'm going to take off both of these gears. Now I'm going to put both of these green gears on here. And again, I want to make sure that they're meshing. And you can see that these gears are exactly the same size, right? There's not one bigger and one smaller. So we're only going to, we only need to test this one once, because even if we flip them back and forth, it's not going to change anything. They're the same size gear. Okay. So I'm going to add both of my shaft collars, going to make sure they're in there nice and tight and they're meshing. And then we'll test the positive and negative direction of this green-green combination. Are you ready? Let's see what happens when we move our switch to the positive side. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Whoa, this is a third totally different kind of design. It looks like we're getting kind of larger sort of ovally rounded shapes, but it seems like it's actually almost making kind of a complete circle, more similar to this one. Interesting. And as it keeps going around, it's getting darker and darker as it traces over its line. So we'll let this go about 3 more seconds and 3, 2, 1 and stop. All right, so it seems like we had really tight spirals in our first configuration. We had super loose and open spirals in our second configuration. And in this configuration, it seems like we have somewhere in between, right? We have kind of medium-shaped spirals. So we're gonna go ahead and label this drawing 2. This is green, green in the positive direction. All right, are we ready to see what else this gear configuration can do? So now we're gonna test this in the negative direction. Think in your brain, what do you think this design might look like when we flip it the other way, right? We can see how the patterns have changed from positive to negative with the other two gear configurations. What do you think this one is going to do? Or do you think it's not gonna change at all because our gears are the same size? Let's find out. Ready? 3, 2, 1, here we go. In the negative direction. Oh my goodness, I think this might be my favorite design yet. Wow, look at that. Where our positive direction made almost a complete circle, this one looks a lot more like a flower to me. Where it's still going around in a spiral, but it almost has like petals coming out of it. All right, we'll let this go for about 3 more seconds and 3, 2, 1, and stop. Now, look at this last design that we've made here. So when we compare this one, look at the difference between how tight and together and in one space this positive direction was, and this one seems to be going almost more outwards together. So this is both of our green gears going in the negative direction. Okay, so now you're probably wondering, wait a minute, Audra, why did we just do all 6 of these? Well, the reason we did all 6 of these was to be able to see the different kinds of designs that our Spirograph can make. Because once we know the different kinds of shapes and patterns that it can make, now we can start to get really creative with it. So we can add some different layers to our Spirograph art. And the first way that we can do that is by changing the color of the drawing. So here I have some colored pencils. So I'm gonna show you how to change out, now that we know how to change out the gears, how to change out our pencil for some different kinds of writing implements. So whenever we wanna change the pencil, we wanna make sure that we take off this end part here where the pencil is. So I'm just gonna pull that out, and it kept, and that should then just go down and sit on my Spirograph right there. I'm gonna slide this up a little bit. And I'm gonna leave those 2 standoffs right in there. Then I'm just gonna pull this pencil out. Depending on the size and shape of your pencil, it might be a little stuck, just give it a little yank. Now I have some colored pencils here. So I'm gonna choose a colored pencil to add to my pencil holder in order to be able to draw in some different colors. Now, since I'm using this bluish paper, I'm gonna use something that I think will turn out really pretty well on that. I'm gonna try this purple pencil. So then I'm just gonna slide it right into the holder, and oh dear, what happened? It seems like this pencil is a little bit smaller than my other one, which you may find depending on the writing implements that you have and the drawing tools that you have wherever you are. So this mechanical pencil fit in here kind of exactly. This one is a little bit loose. So there are 2 things that I can do in order to fix this. One of them is that I can get a rubber band out of my VEX GO kit, and I can wrap the rubber band around the pencil holder part of my build and around this pencil a few different times. You may need to ask a grown-up for help with this. That's okay. We basically want to just get our pencil held in there nice and tight. So I'm going to wrap it around in a bunch of different directions. And now you can see that my pencil is held on there really nice and firmly, and I still have space to connect it. So now I'm going to connect that back to my yellow connector right here. And now I'm going to see what this looks like when I draw a purple design. So let's see what happens. Are you ready? I'm going to go with that same green-green negative combination because I really liked that design. So ready? We'll get it started in 3, 2, 1, go. Ooh, it looks like it's drawing a little bit lighter. And I notice that when I draw regularly with colored pencils, sometimes I have to press a little bit harder. So maybe I just need to let this run a little bit longer in order to make that design nice and dark. So now we can see that it's getting darker the longer that it runs, and it's turning a little bit more purple. And since purple is my favorite color, I'm gonna let that run for about 5 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and stop. Now, what if I wanted to layer another color on top of this? Well, I could totally do that. I just need to detach my pencil holder. I'm gonna take off the rubber band and the pencil. I'm just gonna pull that off there. And if you don't wanna use the rubber band from your kit, you can use a rubber band from your house, that's fine. Ooh, I lost one of my standoffs. Left one standoff in there, I'll do that. All right, now I'm going to change the colored pencil. Let's see, I think along with purple, I'm gonna add a bit of red to see how that works. Now, another way that we can make our pencils and writing implements fit when they're just a little bit small, like this one is we can use some tape and wrap some tape around the pencil just to make it a tiny bit bigger. So here, I'm just gonna grab a little piece of masking tape here, just a small little bit. I don't really need very much. And then I'm going to wrap it around my pencil here. Just roll it around just like that. And now when I slide it in, it's made it just big enough that it fits really nicely and tightly in there. So for me, this is a little bit easier than the rubber band each time, but this is also because my pencil is smaller. If you have a colored pencil or a marker that's bigger, the rubber band is gonna be your best bet. So now when I reattach that, we always wanna make sure that we're attaching it with the pencil side facing out and not upside down the other way, because it won't work quite as well. Okay, so now let's see what happens when we try to layer the red pencil over our purple drawing. We're gonna move the switch in the same direction just to see what happens. 3, 2, 1, go. There we go. Okay, so now I can see that it's adding some red right on top of that purple. So I'm layering the colors of my drawing, but I'm keeping the same design. So the longer this goes, we can see how that changes the color of our drawing as we add red on top of purple. Now, if you're using different color paper, you might want to think about how you can use what you know about color mixing, right? Maybe you want to blend blue and yellow to make a green design using your Spirograph. Here I'm just using red and purple, so it's turning to a little bit of a reddish violet color. I'm gonna hold that for about 3 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, and stop. Now, what do you think would happen if we were to, instead of just layer two colors and two directions? So now I'm going to leave my red pencil in there, but I'm going to flip my switch in the positive direction to see what happens if we combine these two designs in one drawing. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, here we go. So now we can start to see really lightly again, right? Because they're colored pencils, so it takes a minute. We're starting to kind of fill in some of those shapes, and you can see this outer circle here forming within the petal. So if we keep it going, we'll be able to see two solidly discrete patterns, right? As I'm layering more of the red on top, my original purple lines are actually starting to show up a little bit more, right? So we can not only layer two different colors, but we can, or as many as we want. Every time we keep swapping out our pencil, we can layer different colors on top of our design, we can also layer different designs on top of one another. So I'm going to stop it in 3, 2, 1, and stop. And now I'm going to take this design out and we're going to look at this compared to our originals to see what we made here. Whoop, if I can get it out. All right, there we go. Okay, so now if I compare this, let me bring these up a little bit so you can see it a bit better. Let me just move these over. So now if I compare this design to these two, we can look pretty closely and we can see this outer one in the purple, and then we can see these inner circles in the red. Now, if I wanted to, I could go in with another colored pencil, maybe with a green one, and I can see, like, I now have spaces in here. I can start to color in some of those shapes if I want to, right? I could start to add some different details in here if I wanted to. I could even add little designs. I could add spots to different empty spaces in there. So you can use these as a basis for a lot of different kinds of artwork. So now I'm going to see what happens if I layer two different gear configurations on top of one another. So I'm going to change my pencil out one more time. I'm going to go for a bit of a dark green here. Let me add some tape to my pencil to make it fit the way that I want it to. Here we go. And the nice thing about this is that even after I'm done using my Spirograph, this doesn't change anything about the pencil, right? I can still draw and use it regularly and normally. Okay, so that time I just popped the pencil out and I left the pencil holder in place. Sometimes I want to take out the whole pencil holder depending on if I'm using the rubber band, I definitely want to do that. If I'm just sliding it in or out or depending on how my pencil fits, sometimes I don't need to take off the entire thing. Okay, so I think I'm going to start with this design right here, this blue gear to red gear turned in the negative direction. So I'm going to take off my two shaft collars, and my two gears. I'm going to put back on now my blue gear to my red gear. And then I'm going to put the shaft collars on top of them just to make sure they're nice and tightly on there. I'm going to get both sides here, one and two. My gears are meshed. They should be solidly in place. All right, so let's see what happens when we move our switch in the negative direction. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, and go. Here it goes. Now we're getting a green design on my blue paper, and this is a nice bright green. I like this color a lot. So I'm going to let this go to make my snazzy green line right here in 3, 2, 1, and stop. And now let's think about what other design we might want to layer on top of that green design. Well, I think this one might look kind of neat. So I'm going to flip my gears around and you can see the more we practice doing this, the easier this gets for us. So now I'm going to flip my gears to put my red gear on and then my blue gear on, making sure those are mesh, and then I'm going to stick my shaft collars on top here just to keep them nice and tight there. And I'm going to change out the color of my pencil. This time I'm going to take the whole thing off. And let's see, what color do you think would look really nice on top of that green? I'm going to go back to my purple pencil, and I've already put some tape on my purple pencil. So I'm going to go back to purple and put purple and green together and see how that looks. Okay, so now we wanted to make sure that we wanted to use this design plus this design. Okay, are you ready? We're going to turn our switch in the negative direction. 3, 2, 1, here we go. So now we're doing a really detailed design on top of a more open design, and let's see what that does. Now again, when my purple starts moving, it's kind of faint, so I'm probably going to need to hold this in here and have this running a little bit longer to get it to be brighter. But if you wanted it to be very light, then you have complete control over that depending on how long you let your Spirograph run. It gives you a lot of choice and freedom in the way that you make your Spirograph art. So now I can really start to see that design popping out, right? I can see all of those different little interwoven spaces. that are going in and around my green design. So this two-layer design has two different gear configurations and two different colors to it. And we can layer as many colors and designs as you want to, right? I could swap out my pencil right now and add a third one in here if I wanted to, which maybe I kind of want to see what that looks like. What if we added this design as well? What if we did that blue gear to red gear going the other direction? Or what if we added our green gears and we had a combination design here that used all three different gear combinations? So before I swap my pencil color, I'm going to take off my shaft colors and I'm going to put my green gears back on because I kind of like the idea of making one drawing with all three patterns in it. So I'm going to put my green gears on because now we have representation from the red blue, we have representation from the blue red, and now we're going to add a third layer that is the green green. So let's see, I had a green, I had a purple, I'm going to add a red to this one next. So now I'm just going to stick that in there. I'm going to place my pencil on my drawing. And sometimes you can turn tilt this a little bit depending on where you want your drawing to start. So I'm going to start it kind of right there, wherever, where that seems to fit. All right. Are you ready? We're going to make this go, let's see, should we go positive or negative? I think we're going to go negative. All right. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, here we go. Oh, and now I can see my red design starting to pop out on top of this. You can see some of the places that it overlaps with some of the other designs, right? Because we have so many different lines here on our drawing that we can start to see some of the places where the red lines are overlapping with the purple and the green. I'm going to let that go a little bit longer just so that way you can really clearly see the red. So this way it becomes a bit easier to identify all three of these different designs. So we're going to let that go for about 5 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and stop. Oh my goodness. Look at how detailed this design is. So something that I've noticed as we've kept adding to our one drawing is that each time we add another layer, the spaces that we have between the lines, right here, I had big open spaces that I could color in. Here, they're very, very tiny little spaces. I could still color them in with another color if I wanted to or add details to it. But each layer that we add adds different depth and dimension to our artwork. So if we wanted to use our Spirograph art in some larger art, we could do that. So I'm going to move my Spirograph over to the side here, and I'm going to bring in a piece of white paper that I have. And we're going to think about some of the ways that we could use this Spirograph art to make something else new and exciting, right? So if I look at this one up here, it kind of reminds me a little bit of a lion's mane, right? You know how the lion has all of that hair going around its face? So it looks a little bit like a lion's mane. And I bet that if I added some more details to this drawing, I could kind of turn it into a little bit more of a lion-like creature. So I'm going to grab my black marker here. So I'm going to add some eyes to this design in order to make my lion appear a little more clearly. So there's some eyes for my lion, and he's gonna have, I think, a little red nose, a little triangular red nose here, and a smile. And then I'm going to color in some of this design to make it look more like lion's fur. Now, I could do this in a few ways. I could try to trace all of the lines and go around there and do what my Spirograph did. And an interesting thing about doing this is that we can see how long it's taking me to follow these lines and how quickly we made this design for ourselves, right? When we were doing this with our Spirograph, it was so fast. But when I'm trying to just do it on my own, it's a bit trickier, But I think it looks kind of cool. So I'm going to outline some of these lines, not all of them, just some of them, till I get all the way back around. I definitely am not doing as great a job as my Spirograph did. My tracing is a little bit more uneven, but that's okay. We just want to kind of make this look like a lion. So there we go. So now it looks a bit more like a lion's mane, right? I'll add another one over this way. What else do we need here? Our lion needs some ears. So I'm going to add some shapes in here to give him some ears. And my lion probably needs some whiskers, right? Oh, my black marker's dying. So my lion is going to be a kind of funny lion, and he's going to have some blue whiskers coming out of his nose there. And then when I add this to my paper here, I can also draw the rest of my lion around it. So I can draw the rest of my lion's body. I can give it some feet here. He's got really, really big feet. Really big feet, this lion. He's a heavy-duty lion. I'm going to give him his little claws there. And my lion is going to have a nice long tail that comes up here with its bushy end. There we go. And now, not only have I made a super cool Spirograph design, but now I've used it to create some really neat Spirograph art. And if I want to, I can glue that Spirograph piece down to my paper. I'm going to put a little piece of tape on it there, just so this way it stays in place. And now I've made some really neat Spirograph art. And I can keep going with that, right? I could make more animals here. I can add more details to my lion. I can give him more fluffy fur here. I can maybe use some of these little detailed bits to add some flowers to the ground around my lion, because maybe he's in a beautiful place where there's some lovely flowers floating around. I can add this one also. And then maybe I want to, on a drawing like this, maybe I want to trace this one, since it's a bit easier and a bit less detailed. I can trace this one with my marker, and then I can color it in with my colored pencils, right? We have so many different options available to us in order to make this Spirograph art that works the best for us. So now if I were to color this in, now you can see it's really starting to look a lot like a flower, right? We could add some details to the middle of it. We could add the seed pods and things, but we have a lot of different options and ways to use our Spirograph to make some really, really amazing art that is just perfect for you. So whatever speaks to you, whatever kinds of art you want to make, that's what you get to do now. You get to use your Spirograph and all of your knowledge about the gear configurations and how to adjust the pencil and how to use the directions of the switch in order to create the Spirograph art of your dreams. So go forth and have fun making all kinds of Spirograph art. This is our final section of VEX GO STEM Camp, and I know that I have had an absolute blast with you over all of these sessions. We've built some amazing things. We've even built motorized builds, and I just cannot wait to see what else you do with your VEX GO kit. So have a blast with your Spirograph, and I will see you in another camp soon.